Dr. Bruce Fife is the author of over 20 books, including Stop Vision Loss Now and Ketone Therapy. He is the editor of the Healthy Ways newsletter and serves as the director of the Coconut Research Center. The Coconut Research Center is a nonprofit organization dedicated to educating the medical community and the general public about the health and nutritional aspects of coconut and related foods. Today, Dr. Fife joins us to discuss ketone therapy and eye health. Dr. Fife, thank you for joining us.
It's my pleasure to be here. Thank you for having me.
Diet can play an important role in preventing and treating vision problems such as glaucoma, macular degeneration, and diabetic retinopathy. In your book, Stop Vision Loss Now, you talk about ketones. What are ketones?
Yes, ketones are another type of fuel our cells use, similar to glucose. You know, glucose is the primary source of fuel for our bodies, and we get glucose primarily from the carbohydrates in our foods. And if we don't eat for a while, say between meals or during the night when we're sleeping or even when we're fasting, our blood glucose levels start to fall. But our cells need glucose or need energy 24 hours a day. So it needs an alternative source of energy to glucose. And so what the body does is it starts going to its fat stores and starts releasing fatty acids. And our cells can use fatty acids just like it does glucose. So in this manner, the body has access always to either glucose or fatty acids. Now, this process works great for the body, but it doesn't work for the brain because our brains cannot use fatty acids to supply its energy needs, so it needs an alternative source of energy. Well, the liver can take these fatty acids and convert them into ketones, and the brain can use the ketones. So in this manner, the brain and the eyes always have access to either glucose or ketones to supply their energy needs. And you know, the eyes are part of the brain. They're extensions of the brain. So whatever feeds the brain, which is good for the brain, also is good for the eyes and feeds the eyes.
What's so special about ketones?
Ketones are really remarkable, you know, and I can think of four major features about ketones that are really fantastic. One of them is that they provide more energy than glucose does. In fact, they've been called super fuel for the brain because they do provide more energy. It's kind of like putting high-performance gasoline into your car. Your car will run better, have better gas mileage with less wear and tear. So ketones kind of have that type of effect on the brain. And number two is that ketones can increase circulation into the brain. And so that brings in more oxygen and nutrients to feed and nourish the brain and the eyes. Number three, and this is really important, is that ketones stimulate the action of certain proteins in the brain called brain-derived neurotrophic factors. And these neurotrophic factors function in brain cell maintenance, care, and rejuvenation. They provide protection. For example, they help calm inflammation. They stimulate healing and repair and even growth of new brain cells, new neurons, including the neurons in the eye tissue, the optic nerve, and the retina. So they have a stimulatory healing effect on brain and eye tissue. Number four is that they also provide the basic building blocks for new brain cells. And so a lot of your brain is actually made from ketones. And so these ketones provide this basic building block, including your eye tissue. Basic building blocks come from ketones. And so it's really important that you have ketones coming into your brain on a regular basis to provide the building blocks to repair damaged brain tissue and eye tissue and build new tissues to be healthy. And so for all these conditions or for all these reasons, ketones can have a very pronounced therapeutic effect on the brain and the eyes.
What health issues can be treated with ketone therapy?
It's really interesting because ketones have been used to treat a wide variety of neurological problems such as epilepsy, Alzheimer's disease, Parkinson's disease, stroke, traumatic brain injury, and even eye conditions. And it's interesting, for example, with the Alzheimer's, they're using ketones to treat Alzheimer's disease, and they found that it can stop the progression of the disease and even reverse it to some extent. For example, Alzheimer's patients that have progressed to the point where they can no longer read or write, once they start getting the ketone therapy, they can have been able to regain the ability to read and write, go on the internet, you know, and surf the internet. Some who have been so far gone that they cannot form a sentence, they can't talk, they more babble. Once they get onto ketone therapy, it's been reported numerous times, where they are able to speak in clear sentences again. And so it has a very therapeutic effect that way. In eye conditions, it's interesting where they've done studies where they've actually severed the optic nerve of lab animals. And then with the ketones and the neurotropic factors associated with them, the optic nerve has been regenerated. And these animals who were blind because the optic nerve was separated was able to regain eyesight. Now they weren't able to gain total eyesight, but the fact that they were able to regain eyesight is remarkable. And it's through these ketones this can happen.
Ketone therapy has proven very successful in treating neurological conditions such as epilepsy and Alzheimer's disease. Since the eyes are extensions of the brain, it makes sense that ketone therapy could have a similar positive impact on visual health as well. What can you do to increase blood ketone levels to have these positive effects?
Well, there's a few ways you can do it. The most obvious and typical way is through fasting, because when you're fasting, your blood glucose levels start coming down and your body is producing fatty acids and ketones. But, you know, you can only fast for a certain amount of time. So another method is to use a ketogenic diet. And a ketogenic diet is a very low-carb, high-fat diet. In fact, the ketogenic diet was specifically created to produce therapeutic blood levels of ketones. And it was developed almost 100 years ago specifically to treat epilepsy, and has been very successful in treating epilepsy, even better than drug therapy. A third method of increasing blood ketones, and probably the easiest method, is to consume coconut oil. Now, coconut oil is unique among all the oils in our diet in that it is composed predominantly of a special type of fatty acid known as medium-chain fatty acids. And when we consume coconut oil, these medium-chain fatty acids are automatically converted into ketones. And it doesn't matter what your blood sugar levels are or what other foods you're eating in the diet, the coconut oil will still be converted into ketones. And so if you eat enough coconut oil, you can actually increase your blood levels to mild therapeutic levels of ketones. And so through diet, you can have the benefits of these ketones. And of course, you can also combine these methods if you want to enhance any of them.
In your book, you describe how ketone therapy can be used to repair damage to the optic nerve and retina caused by degenerative diseases such as glaucoma and macular degeneration. coconut oil by itself or in combination with a ketogenic diet appears to offer some degree of protection against these degenerative eye problems. How can we incorporate coconut oil into our daily diet?
Yeah, you know, in order to get the ketone effect of the coconut oil, you've got to eat more than just a teaspoon or two. I recommend 1 to 5 tablespoons a day. So 1 teaspoon, 3 teaspoons equals 1 tablespoon. And so I recommend 2 to 5 tablespoons a day. And in order to get this in your diet, the easiest way would be in any recipes that you use in the home that call for vegetable oil, butter, margarine, or shortening, just substitute coconut oil in its place and be free with using it. Now, you know, don't limit the amount of oil. Add a little extra oil in it to get the benefit, because coconut oil is a healthy oil, a health-promoting oil. It's good for the brain. It's good for the eyes. It's good for the heart. It's good for the entire body. And even in foods that don't require any oil in its processing, you can add it in. For example, you can use coconut oil as a spread on bread. You can put it on rice. You can put it in oatmeal. You can put it in soups and stews and curries. You can put it on hot vegetables. You can mix it up and use it as a salad dressing. So there are many types of foods and ways in which you can add coconut oil into your diet. Now, I recommend that you always consume coconut oil with foods. You know, oftentimes I'll take a spoonful of coconut oil and just put it in my mouth that way. And you can do that, but I still recommend that you eat it along with foods, because oftentimes we have moved away from eating a lot of fat and our bodies have become a little unused to eating so much fat. And when people start adding a lot of fat into their diet, they may experience a little diarrhea. And if they eat it with foods, it cuts down that a little bit. And if they can eat it with a source of dietary fiber, such as psyllium husk, that also will get rid of the potential for diarrhea. In fact, I recommend approximately 1 teaspoon of psyllium husk for every tablespoon of coconut oil to help relieve any type of diarrhea you might experience. Not everyone experiences that, but people who are more sensitive to diets and their fat may have that experience. And so just add a little dietary fiber, soluble fiber of some type.
Thank you, Dr. Fife, for sharing this information with us about ketones, coconut oil, and eye health. To learn more about Dr. Fife and his work, go to his website at www.coconutresearchcenter.org. That's www.coconutresearchcenter.org. For more information about ketone therapy and coconut oil and how they can be used to prevent and treat common vision problems, see Dr. Fife's books, Stop Vision Loss Now and Ketone Therapy.